About all the things, the hard news and all that. Today we're here to do soft but tragic but sometimes also emotional topics today. But that is why we have to start today's show with this motivation. It's a story, really. It's gonna take a little bit long, but if you have the ears and the eyes, you can know that this is fruitful. It starts like this. Once upon a time, an old man spread rumors that his neighbor was a thief. And as a result, the young man was arrested. Days later, he was proven innocent. After being released, he sued the old man for wrongfully accusing him. In court, the old man told the judge, and I quote, "They are just comments. They didn't harm anyone," unquote. The judges, before passing sentence on the case, told the old man, and again I'm quoting, "Write all the things you said about him on a piece of paper. Cut it up into little pieces, and on your way home, throw the pieces of the paper out of your car window. Tomorrow, come back to hear the sentence," unquote. The next day, the judge told the old man, before receiving the sentence, "I want you to go out and gather all the pieces of paper that you threw out of your car window yesterday," the old man said. I quote, "I can't do that," the man said. "The wind spread them all over the place, and I won't know where to find them." Then the judge replied, "The same way, just simple words and comments may destroy the honor of a person to such an extent that a person will not be able to fix them. If you can't speak well of someone, don't say anything at all. Let's all be masters of our lips, of our mouths, so that we won't be slaves of our words. Indeed, gossips are worse than thieves. You know why? Because they steal another person's dignity. Indeed, they steal another person's honor, reputation, and credibility, which are impossible to restore. I know that because I'm a media person. We write other things about people, etc. But it's even worse what we say in the office, at home, against a neighbor, in the community, etc. Or even in the church or the mosque. So remember this. When your feet slip, you can always recover your balance. But when your tongue slips, you can never indeed recover your words. Mind your words. Be mindful of your tongue and be mindful of what you say. Because what you say could make somebody's day for the rest of his life. Well, thanks for joining us for the show. Throughout the show, you can get interactive on Facebook. Join Us on TV is the name of the page where you can find us, because we're streaming there. On our YouTube channel, Majo Online TV, you can find us there, as well as our multi-TV platforms on the internet. As you do that, please know that we have our interactive handle on Twitter, Journeys on TV. But today, let's tell you what we're about to do. What do you do when the relationship you're in depresses you? How do you deal with a partner who is constantly causing you to be depressed? Well, our guest will be a renowned relationship expert. He's a regular on the show, Amos Kevin Annan, will be telling us all about depressive relationships. Well, we're all victims, or perhaps we're also perpetrators. We tend to prey on others' depression or others' emotional weaknesses. Well, there's also a story of a young man who's stopped schooling simply because he's got the call from God to become a pastor. This got us thinking around here. At what point do you decide or decipher between being a scholar, being an academic, and becoming a man of God, or indeed stopping school at all to listen to that voice you say is a call? Can a person be both at the same time diligently? Should you shun school just to answer the call of God? And we'll be joined by Reverend John Kato. He's the head of administration, the Charismatic Evangelistic Ministry. But today, a group is launching a book on child marriage. And so it's encouraging girls who escape the snares of child marriages not to relent in their effort to attain their aims. And so we'll bring you all that today. We'll wrap up with an entertainment package. And then we'll take you to the chat room in that entertainment package today. But please know that we'll do a recap of all that has happened for the week as well. Well.